Hi, I'm Chandrika R. Krishna. Thank you, Meera, for this opportunity for me to read some of my favorite poems for Poetry Raga Maya Katha. Here it goes. Mother's Tribute. This particular poem is an anonymous one, and I found it recently when I was taking some sessions for NIFT students. Mother's Tribute. Dear Mother, so much in my heart I want to express. At one, I wanted to sleep next to you all night. At two, I wanted to hold your hand and never let it go. At five, I wanted to share my daily stories from nursery. At ten, I wanted to hang out with my girlfriends. At 12, I wanted to do my own thing. At 16, I kept secrets. At 20, I found my own. Life was busy managing social affairs. At 25, I was consumed with career ambitions, men, and big life plans. At 30, I was getting married and wanted you to celebrate in my joy. At 35, the grandkids arrived. I felt what you felt when I was born. At 40, I missed you, wished to see you more. At 50, my heart ached for the pain you were suffering. I really missed you. At 60, I was nostalgic, revering in my childhood memories of you and Daddy. Dear Mother, your presence makes life worthwhile. It blooms hope in every dark corner. It allows us to truly experience and give unconditional love. You make my soul feel warm. May our souls be entwined forever, not just together. Thank you. The second poem that I had selected was Border Guards by Shiv K. Kumar. Why did I select this? I remember reading this poem or taking this poem for my final lesson during my B.Ed. sessions. And it made me feel really tearful. And so here it goes. Border Guards by Shiv K. Kumar. On the other side of the impregnable fence, enmeshed with warlords' gory threats and counter threats, whimpered my counterpart over a letter from home. His wife's illness, his son's death, his recoilless gun sitting negligently between his knees. My fingers bleed to think of the fence's spikes that will not let me caress his anguished face of this other man, my country's alleged enemy, but my soul's brother in loneliness. War doesn't help anyone, right? Unfortunately, it is a sad part of life. And now I come to the third poem, which is my own, which I had written some couple of decades back. Flightless Birds. Sleepless nights and colic pains, nappy wash and nappy rash, wailing and crying, teething and dripping. Oh, when will it be before they grow wings of their own? Schooling and swatting, squabbling and screaming, classwork's not done, homework yet to be done, the endless wails of ribbons lost and spencers misplaced. Oh, when will it be before they grow wings of their own? Pimples and aches, dates and mates, sighs and moans, puppy love and scouts, not enough clothes, not enough money, admissions and entrance, the never-ending tensions. Oh, when will it be before they grow wings of their own? Occasional calls and occasional letters, the endless days and the endless nights, nothing misplaced and nothing to do, aches and moans of tired growing bones, the endless silence of an empty home. Oh, why did they have to grow wings of their own? Well, I wrote this poem when my children were in the second stage of my life. And when I read it, I think, wow, Chandrika, you were really far-sighted, because now that I am in the fourth stage of my life, I really do miss my children. I hope you enjoyed all the three poems as much as I enjoyed reading them. Thank you, Meera, once again for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.